I wonder, do you Americans understand right now why we need a new system of government? We watch things happen all across the world. Venezuela, not too long ago, you remember the problems that they are going through. They are going through some major stuff. Matter of fact, they see people fighting for food. Well, with this pandemic going on, you never know what's going to happen because we are not getting true information from the leadership. They just keep lying and lying and lying and lying and lying. Now, why are they lying? Here is why they're lying, ladies and gentlemen. Because you, the people of this country, truly are not important to those that run this country. Now, that doesn't mean that you're not important to others. You are important, no doubt. But you're not important to the people who run this country. The people who run this country, the only thing that's important to them is money. Money, money. So if they can make a little bit more money while you're trying to figure out whether you're going to live or die or not, they're going to try to make all the money they possibly can. And they're going to try to set it up so when this thing is over, they can continue to make as much money as they can possibly can. And in the process, going to do every kind of lying they can possibly do. Now, who are they lying to? We, the people. Now, here's the question. Are we, the people, foolish enough to hear somebody say something and then tell ourselves they didn't say it? Are we foolish enough to see somebody do something and then tell ourselves that they didn't do it, even when the consequence is a pain and suffering for we, the people? I mean, if that happens, we definitely better need a savior. We definitely need a savior because we ain't gonna never save ourselves. But the opportunity, ladies and gentlemen, is there for us. Now, there might be some rough times. We might find ourselves when the cover is pulled back that there might be such a devastation across this world that food production and all those other things that we have set up on a global basis, this might be stagnant. We can't do anything. You know, there was a time when you could take care of your own house, take care of your own country, but you spread it across the nation trying to get money. It wasn't love and compassion for other nations. It was trying to get money. Globalization had nothing to do with the people coming together for the benefit of the people. It was all about making money. So I tell you, ladies and gentlemen, we can look at this coronavirus and hate what it's doing to us. But we can also allow it to draw us together to make sure that nothing like this ever happens to us again. Make sure that no liar can come up here and tell us he's the best for us. Tell us just what we want to hear, at least a segment of us who have suffered, because we have all suffered. Sure, white people have suffered something. Black people have suffered something. Tall people have suffered something. Black, short people have suffered something. But we all still are people. And the essentials of life we all require. None of us are after those requirements. And those are the things that are common amongst us that we as people should make sure that no one ever interfere with again. So I say to you, let's deal with this coronavirus. Let's stop even pointing fingers at the Trump administration. Let's stop pointing fingers at the Republicans and Democrats because we have all failed. The Republicans failed, the Democrats failed, and we as citizens of this nation failed because we played a part in it, and all of us are guilty. Every last one of us are guilty. So I tell you right now, if you got a time, you're not sick, or if you're sick, think. Think about what is happening. Think about what you would like to happen. Think about if you're going to die. Where do you want to go? You want to go to hell or do you want to go to heaven? Think about that. Those of you who are not dying, what do you want to do? Do you want to live a prosperous, great life or you just want to struggle? Well, you know, I don't know what kind of life you come from, but right now we can get a new beginning, a brand new beginning, because all the resources of this earth belong to God. The oil, everything, the food, this ability to grow, all of that stuff belongs to a power we can't see, can't touch, and can't feel. And the people that's needed to be able to cause those things to manifest so they can be used are we the people. And every last one of us got a role that we can play in that process, entitling us to a portion of all of that which is created by the hands of man. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't care who you are, black or white, rich or poor, God from heaven, or the devil, you can't add to that anything that's better. Well, I hope you can. I mean, that ain't the best, but that's darn sure better than where we're coming from. But the power to make that change is in our hands. In our hands. We don't need a leader. I'm telling you right now, these are the things that I want, and I know you want them too. And I'm not going to say, I don't want them because a white man might have to have some. I don't believe a white man would say, I don't want them because a black man going to have some. I don't want life because a black man going to have life. I don't believe anyone is saying that. So the trick they've done is caused us to fight against one another. And I want to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, the message that I'm telling you is coming from inside of me. But I want you to know that was the message that I was taught about God. That I'll say it again. That was the message, the kind of message that I was taught about God. So I want to represent what I understand God to be. Now, I don't know who you represent, but it has nothing to do with the God that I'm talking to you about. But I'll stand up and offer my God to you. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for giving me this your time. Have a good one.